Very good morning to students. Welcome to the online class for the mind planning. Environmental control in minds. You are in the various type of environmental laws in which today we are going to learn about the Air Act 1981. The Air Act 1981. So you see here the 1981, our Water Act will be in 1974. After 7 years later, the Air Act will be enacted in the Parliament. These also backbone the majorly, we well known that in Stockholm, United Nations, our Indians participated, take many more number of decisions. But in 1974, the Water Act will come into the force, and after 7 years, the requirement of the air pollution control is also mandatory, so that the Air Act is enacted. In Water Act, we have restricted some states more. That is, 13 states are mentioned in that one. But the Air Act is applicable to whole of India. In majorly, in silent features of this one, almost to the near to the Water Act, the chapters is also same, and also the boards which are the going to the chapter 2 and 3, the functions are similar to the in what are said in the Water Act. Coming to the silent features of the Air Act and its basic objectives. Coming to this one, they have the preliminaries. In preliminaries, we are giving to the all the definitions that we well known similarly in the Water Act. In this one, it is particularly mentioning the what is the definition of air pollutant. As per we well known that the air pollutant means any concentrations of the air or gases pollutant, or including noise, the concentrations which is affecting the human environment as well as the inner living creature. This is a specific mention. The concentration is more, where is the air pollution is more, that is called air pollution. That with definitions, all the definitions and occupiers, who is the industrialist, what are the basic definitions, all are in covered in the first chapter, the preliminaries. And similar coming to the chapter 2, the central state boards, as well as you know that is similar to the Water Act. There is a state pollution board, the control board is there, as well as central pollution control board is there. These two, it will be jointly, it's called joint boards. They were sharing their remits. We know that what are the basics of the, there is a chairman is there, in the state one chairman and a central also chairman is there. Is a well knowledge and a sound experience in the environmental protection acts and environmental sites. And also a member secretary is also the well experienced personality in the fishery department or forest department is nominated. So these two are the permanent members, the full-fledged members. And another five members is nominated from the central board and as well as the state board. And another 3 members from the various trade members. So these are the group of members will be work together as a board members. So coming to the power and functions, this is very important to the engine. I am giving to the basics things of the functions of the boards. Here is up to more than 5 to 6 points are they have given written. Advise the government, the board's members, that is a central board members or state board members, the advice to the time to time, the situations to the government, the concerned government, and execute the programs, the different programs of the government going announced depending upon the decision taken in the parliament, depending in the assembly, depending upon the world meets, that will be execution. The body is the state board, pollution board, and central boards. Next, disseminating the information. So, transferring the information. For example, there will be some Kolkata and Mumbai pollution, some CO2 percent is more. So, they will be disseminating the information to the public. That is also very clear role maintaining by these boards. And collaborate with the central boards. So, every state board have the collaborating with the central board, because it is not restricted to boundaries or fiscal boundaries. It is air. So that they require the other states' collaboration is also important. And coming to to inspect the facilities, the various industries you are establishing in the different types. So you have to checking and inspect the such facilities. and air pollution, so inspect the air pollution center control areas, different type of industries we are establishing there. So we have to control in that one, and also making a standards. So standards also very important. Air standards in a different locations, so there will be, for example, any forest areas, there is any endangered species there, for which there will be standardized standards. And similarly, advice to the suitable tough industries, any functions entrusted by the state government will be announced, that will be, and also establishment of the laboratory. This is very important. What is the way to getting the analysis? So each have state government its own and central government have laboratories with their establishment, the major functions of the boards. And coming to the other point is the funds and accounts and audits. So what is the mean by funds and accounts and audit? The funds required from the state government as well as the national wise funds are will be utilizing for the controlling of the air pollution, and also the international standards also. You know, you see the Bharat vehicles B6, B7, B7, B8 is there. So depending upon the situations is also they are tapping the fund. Not only that one, their carbon credit system is also there. So you know well now Tirupati is the best carbon credit. That means you give the other points will be according to that one. They will get the points that will be can sharing to the other, because one area we have to protect the utilizing the renewable energy, and some area we have done able to, so it will be application, that is sun, most of the in Tirupati trust utilizing the that sun power, utilizing the power, so there is a zero carbon will be produced, that is carbon called carbon credits. These everything will be auditing here. Funds and the auditing department, they will be executing that one. And also the penalty and procedure. So this is very important to inspection the industries in the government or private organizations, when they identify the any standards deviations and also not following the laboratory standards, then they can penalize, and punishment is also announced here, the penalty and procedures of ENL, and also various forms are available in the miscellaneous things. So overall, the act is basically the prevention, means prevent the not more than standards will be, the giving the some controlling equipment, so that to see that controlling the prevent the coming out of the industrial chimneys or by vehicle movement or in any other manner of just like our mining explosives, utilizations here, or transportation of the vehicle from the coal one place to other place. These things will be under preventing the various techniques they apply. Another thing, that prevention and control. What is meant by control? Controlling had to start increasing that one. You have to control by the equipments. So that is also you have mentioned. Prevention, abatement. If this crossed, what are the steps you have to take? These will be mentioned in the complete picture in the Air Act 1981. Prevention and control and abatement of the air pollution. So this is the overall picture of the environmental laws, one of the Air Act. I think you can understand the basic objective and the scope of the Air Act 1981. Thank you.